The year is 1969. It's the age of Aquarius, the time of the hippies, the year of peace, music, and love at Woodstock, and the year after the off-Broadway musical Hair opened. Tom Wolfe published The Electric Kool-Aid Acid Test, The Beatles, Big Brother, and The Holding Company, The Doors, and Joni Mitchell were at the top of the charts. We were stardust, we were golden, and we had to get ourselves back to the garden. Was it any wonder that this next episode of Star Trek, broadcast in early 1969, was about a group of intergalactic hippies who were trying to do just that? The garden in this story is a planet called Eden, and the hippies are led by a Dr. Severin who bears more than a little resemblance to someone named Dr. Timothy Leary. Now, the way to Eden. In reading the script, Walter Koenig noticed that his Chekhov character had become inflexible. A conservative type A personality, he was not quite different than how he was originally created. He was light years away from the type of person that young people of 1969 could relate to. Spock, on the other hand, dons a Jimi Hendrix persona and prefers to hang out with a bunch of space hippies rather than his Enterprise cohorts. He must have found something appealing about the freewheeling hippie life. That'll teach Dr. Severin to eat the fruit of paradise. Why is it that we always seem to get into trouble eating fruit? Eve really shouldn't have eaten that apple, but if she hadn't, would we still be living in some ignorantly blissful naked state? Would we be devoid of knowledge and lacking shame? It would seem that the concept of paradise always involves a compromise. Maybe Snow White was the one who got off easy. All she did after eating her apple was take a long nap. It seems that Dr. Severin was one of those people who just can't win.